thank you for the glory. We want to thank you, Jehovah God, for you set aside this day, my God and my Father, that we may come and bring our worship unto thee, my God and my Father, our praises unto thee, my God and my Redeemer. How we sanctify ourselves to the blood of Jesus as we welcome your presence, King of all the glory, trusting that, Jehovah God Almighty, our hearts are going to be filled, Jehovah God, this morning, King of all the glory. We pray that, Jehovah God, we continue increasing as you increase in our life, Jehovah. Bless us, Jehovah God Almighty, King of all the glory, in everything we are going to do, my God and my Father. Let us do it to the honor and glory of your name. We worship and we adore you. In Jesus' name we pray, trust and believe.
Amen.
Morning, church.
Morning.
I will request our brother Harrison to read for us, to give us the first reading.
Morning, church. First reading from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, starting from verse 5 to 10. Jeremiah 17, starting from verse 5 to 10. I'm reading from the NIV version. The Bible says, "This is what the Lord says: cursed is the one who trusts in man, who depends on flesh for his strength, and whose heart turns away from the Lord. He will be like a bush in the wasteland. He will not see prosperity when it comes. He will dwell in parched places of the desert, in a salt land where no one lives. But blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him. He will be like a tree planted by the water that set out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when it comes. Its leaves are always green. There's no worries in a year of drought and never fails to bear fruit. The heart is deceitful above all things and beyond cure. Who can understand it? I, the Lord, searches the heart and examine the mind to reward a man according to his conduct, according to what his deeds deserve." Brothers and sisters, this is the word of God.
Our second reading,
Sister Mary. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Our second reading is taken from the book of Luke, chapter 6, from verses 20 to 26. The book of Luke, chapter number 6, from verses 20 to verse 26. And the word of God says, "Then he lifted up his eyes toward his disciples and said, Blessed are you poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who hunger now, for you shall be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you shall laugh. Blessed are you when men hate you, and when they exclude you and revile you and cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake. Rejoice in that day and live for joy, for indeed your reward is great in heaven. For in like manner their fathers did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full, for you shall hunger. Woe to you who laugh now, for you shall mourn and weep. Woe to you when all men speak well of you, for so did their fathers to the false prophets." And that's the word of God.
Thanks.
Son of God. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you so, so very much for blessing us again with such a beautiful day. This is not a duplicate of last Sunday, neither is it a duplicate of yesterday, but this is a brand new day that you have given us with your own good purpose. And how I pray that this morning that we will allow your Holy Spirit to move in our midst. Holy Spirit of God, come. Holy Spirit of God, come. Holy Spirit of God, come. We know that you are a person that has mind, that has will, that searches. You are the one that teaches us good things. Holy Spirit of God, many other times we wrong you, we lie unto you, at times we even insult you. But the Holy Spirit of God, how we pray that this morning, come Lord and teach us, search us, sanctify us, help us, oh God, even as you left Jesus Christ. You said you will not just leave us like prodigal children, but you will give us a helper who is the Holy Spirit. And when the helper comes, he will convict men and women about sin. He will teach us about righteousness, and he will also caution us about the judgment. This morning we need you, Holy Spirit of God, to come and take charge, to come and help us, help our unbelief this morning. Come, help us where we have a mindset that nothing can change what we know and believe. Help us to be open to you, that we may walk in our lives. Fill us this morning. Come, Holy Spirit of God, and take charge in the mighty name of Jesus. And this moment, we shut out every other voice from the kingdom of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray that the Holy Spirit of God is taking charge now. Release your heart, Christian, to the Holy Spirit this morning, that it may minister to each and every one of us. Father, we love you, that this hour you have something special for each and every one of us. And this is my prayer of faith in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. What is your feeling? I really want to thank God for this day that the Lord has allowed us to be in and also alive this morning. We know of our friends, of our colleagues, of our brothers who we were relating very well with, and they are no more. Personally, I have lost a colleague at work, and he was just healthy. What have I done to my Maker that I am alive this morning? I really want to thank God for the gift of life this morning, and you can also thank God with me for the gift of life this morning. Today, I want to thank God for my article allowing me to be in this pulpit. I know it is just a favor, because this pulpit belongs to him. So in absentia, I really want to thank my archdeacon and also the leadership of the church. This morning, I have a very simple word. Blessed or cursed. Just look at your neighbor. Just repeat those words. Blessed or cursed. Blessed. The matter is in your hand. To either choose blessings or you choose curse. The matter is in your hands. And so we take courage and just embrace what you choose this morning. We had some very beautiful readings this morning that were read to us by our evangelist. One was from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, from verse 5 to 10, and the other text was taken from the book of Luke, chapter 6, from verse 20 to 26. And that is where we are going to dwell on this morning. And I know that the Lord has something good for each and every one of us. My name is Ben Wangi. I love Jesus. He's my personal Savior. Very many years back, I said yes to Jesus. And I enjoy being in the Lord. Because for about 5 years, 36 years, I've enjoyed a sweet walk with my Maker. And I have purpose within my soul that I want to serve God all the days of my life. I am married to only one wife, Alice Nyambura, and she will be attending the next service. And we're also blessed with very many children, and we thank God. I like the way Jesus was doing things. And that makes me go back to the text that was read to us on the book of Luke chapter 6 from verse 20. And Jesus, being God and in this world, lifted up his eyes towards his disciples and said these beautiful words. Blessed are you poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. I believe he was looking at his disciples and he was seeing men who have purposed to be poor in the things of this world, to be poor in the things of ungodliness, and chosen to follow Christ. He again looked at them and said, blessed are you who hunger now, for you will be filled. He could see people who are anxious, who are eager who have the hunger of the word of God, and for sure they were filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you shall laugh. There was no butter and bread following Jesus. It was a big task. It was a commitment. It was a sacrifice. But they chose to follow Jesus. And Jesus was looking at his disciples. And he continued, blessed are you when men hate you, and when they exclude you, and revile you, and cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake. He was aware that the friends that they used to be with were not talking good things about them. But nevertheless, they decided to stick with Jesus. Whether they are hated, whether they are appreciated, whether they are included in those very important forums, that did not matter to the disciples. They had chosen Christ. And they stood firm. Jesus continued to talk to them. And he said, rejoice in that day and leap for joy. For indeed your reward is great in heaven. For in like manner of their fathers, they did to the prophets. He told them there is nothing new that was happening in their life. To be sidelined, it doesn't matter. But stick to where you have chosen. Stick to the mark. And I believe the disciples were encouraged to continue walking with Jesus. And this morning, I don't know whether you fall in the category of these wonderful beatitudes that Jesus talked of, these blessings that he was talking about, because of choosing Christ. Today, my theme is blessed or cursed. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 5 to 10. The Bible is so clear that cursed is the person who puts his trust in man. And then the story continues. These words were written by a young man, a prophet of God, a man chosen by God, a man who had decided to work for the Lord, though he was appointed by God when he was still in his mother's womb. Jeremiah was born from a family of priests. And so even when he started his ministry, he was well versed with the word of God because he was brought up in the things of God. And he decided to stick to the things of God. And now he is the author of the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah came along about 60 years after Isaiah had died. And he was a prophet in the southern kingdom of Judah. And at Judah, the Israelites, the Bible puts it so clearly, that the Judah at that time, they were living a very bad life. They were wicked. In fact, the Bible, if you read from verse number 1 of Jeremiah chapter 17, you will see that their sins were like, they were engraved. So their sins were too much, such that it was not easy to remove them. But Jeremiah was talking to such kind of people. And he told them, it is time to put your trust in God. Because when you continue putting your trust in the things that are physical, you remain cursed. Jeremiah was classified as a prophet of doom because he did not have a time to joke around with them. He could just tell them the right things. And he delivered a message of judgment to these people. At around 648 BC is when he started his ministry. And he was in the ministry for over 40 years. And he was very, very young when he was doing all this. He was only 21 years old. And actually, he even pleaded of his inexperience and inability to speak. But he always received information from up above. He used to listen to God. He would never say anything of his own, but he was keenly listening to the instruction from his Maker. He was speaking messages which were full of authority. He had a divine protection, because at times when you come with messages that are not being embraced, at times you also fear. And he had to fear because he was saying things against what was happening in the authority. He could tell them that this is wrong and you must change. And he did not fear anyone because he had a mission to accomplish. The Bible says that because of the mission that he was involved in, if you read Jeremiah 16 verse 2, God even instructed him, in fact commanded him, not to get married. Because he was in serious business. He was in serious business that he could not maybe, he could not handle a family because of the kind of task that was in his hands. And so he did not get married, neither did he have children. And he was living a very difficult life. Starting from his own brothers, if you read chapter 12, verse 6, he was hated by his own brothers. He was threatened to be killed by his own neighbors. The kings were following him up. They wanted to finish him. He was put into prison. And a lot of bad things happened to this man of God called Jeremiah. But I want to tell you, nevertheless, he stood to his divine calling. And he did all that the Lord instructed him to do. Jeremiah was preaching or was bringing down the information from God during the times of four kings. There was Josiah, there was Joahaz, there was Jehoiakim and Zedekiah. Josiah was a very godly man. But come down to his sons, they were very ungodly. And Jeremiah would not escape going to them and telling them what God is saying. And this morning, I want to remind all of us that the ministry that we are involved in is a ministry that is full of seriousness. There is no room to play around. Jeremiah knew all these things, and he knew the repercussions, he knew the consequences of him standing against what other people liked. He knew the consequences of not getting involved in what other people want to hear, because there are messages that people like hearing. But you tell them about wickedness, you tell them about sin, you tell them about such things, you are not afraid. But Jeremiah did not mind. I remember there is a time he went and stood at the entrance of the synagogue, I don't know for whatever reason, and he would address every person who was headed to the synagogue, and he could tell them, my brothers, my sisters, as much as you are headed to the sanctuary, as much as you are headed to the synagogue, amend your ways, do the right things, stop wickedness, don't do this, don't do that. And he could not fear, and he could tell them everything. And this morning he is reminding us, blessed is the person who puts his trust in God, but cursed is the man who put his trust in man. Do you know these are the kind of people who just rely on what somebody has to say and then they are able to move on? Those are the people who are, we are told they are cursed, because they just rely on the one that will be saved by so and so, and they will just follow man. And I wonder, why do we follow man, and man is full of sinful nature? Why do we put our trust in man? Man has lost his integrity. Man, why should we put our trust in man? This morning, when we put our trust in man, we are just putting a cheat upon ourselves. The Bible is clear on this matter, and it says that we are being blinded when we do that. And it is my prayer that this morning we will choose God. Because God, he will never disappoint us. He has never disappointed me. But man, I have seen man disappoint me. I have made plans with men and they have failed me. I have done great things with men and I have seen a lot of failures. But I am telling you, put your trust in God. Even when you are alone, God is with you to give you company, to give you strength, to move on, regardless of what is happening in the world. You know, I like the way my wife tells me in most cases, why should somebody hate somebody who knows they are God? Even if I hate you and you know you are God, I don't know what business you have with your God. So I'm just wasting my time when I just decide to hate so and so. When I just decide to sideline so and so, we are forgetting that they have their God. And they have put their trust in their God. And even you will continue hating them, and God will continue raising them. Why? Because they have known the secret. This morning, I wish we would know the secret of allowing God to be our refuge. We will enjoy the goodness of the Lord when we allow God to be our refuge. A blessed person is a well-protected person. A blessed person will also enjoy good health. A blessed person will enjoy a good family. A blessed person is happy because his sins are forgiven. A blessed person is willing to obey the law. A blessed person has the fear of God. A blessed person is ready to suffer for Christ as Jeremiah did. A blessed person will enjoy even going through temptations because he is assured of victory. Paul said, if I die, I got no problem. If I live, I continue doing the work of God. These are words of a righteous person. These are words of somebody who understands times. We are living in very difficult times, and we just need to choose God. Let us go and learn from people like Noah, Abraham, Isaiah, Jeremiah. You know, people who had actually surrendered their lives to Jesus. Somebody like Jeremiah said, "Fine, Lord, I hearken to your voice, and I will do exactly to what you say." Jeremiah was in the ministry for over 40 years, and it was not sweet. In fact, there's a time he was thrown somewhere in a pit which was full of mud. There was no water, there was no food, and he was all suffering because of speaking the truth, telling people the right things to do. But he did not change his mind. He stood to the ministry that he was called upon. And this morning, it's my prayer that we trust the Lord no matter what is happening in our lives. Let us find peace of mind in our Lord Jesus, even during those times of difficulties. At times it is not easy when you are standing for the truth. Sometimes it is not easy when you tell people the truth. When you tell people it's not about physical. It's not all about physical. But we need to mind about the spiritual man. Because soon and very soon, we will not be in this world for long. I like the way the preacher puts it in his book, chapter 9, verse 10, that in this life, we do what we are able to do with all our might and our strength. Why? Because when we are headed to death, and there is no wisdom, there is no comfort, there is nothing when we go to the grave. So whatever we are doing, we do it, and we do it with all our might. And I was wondering, what am I doing? What is at my disposal? What am I doing? What is there that has been laid upon me? Is it good things or wickedness or bad things? What am I putting all my effort on? May the Lord help us that we do the right things, because soon and very soon Jesus will be revealed. And I am wondering, where will I be? Where will you be? Are you among those people who rely on people? Have you put your trust in God? Have you allowed God to be your master? Have you opened up your hearts that the Holy Spirit may fill you and fill you with good things? This morning we were discussing about the Holy Spirit, and we concluded the matter by saying, when we open our hearts, our house is our hearts. When we allow the Holy Spirit to indwell us and to fill us, there will be no room for anything else. When the devil tries to knock in, he finds that it's all packed. There is no room for him to come in. May the Lord help us to open up and allow the Holy Spirit of God to come in. And when the Spirit of God is in us, we remain blessed men and women of God. Why? Because we are able now to put in true values in the house of God. We will be able to put true values, not pretending values, but true values in the house of God. Jeremiah chose to build and warn people concerning the status of God. What is your choice this morning? What are you doing in the house of God? Are you just here to be counted? Are you here to serve the Lord? Are you here to be recognized? Are you here to look for sympathy? Are you here because you have a mission to accomplish? Are you here with a mission? I always tell people in the house of God, there's nothing called a bench warming people. We need to be somewhere working for the Lord. Because when he calls me, I will answer. Are you ready to hear the voice of the Lord this morning? By choosing to put all your trust in him and put man asunder. Let us all stand up. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you because in your ministry is full of holiness, ministry is a ministry of power. In your ministry, it's a ministry that is not like any other ministry. And how I pray in the name of Jesus that you're going to speak to each and every one of us in this sanctuary. And we choose to put our trust in you because the matter is in our hands. Many other times we have trusted men and they have failed us miserably. Many other times we have put our trust in men and they were very fast to finish us. Many other times we have put our trust in men and our families have even suffered a lot. But we thank you, King of all the glory. Jeremiah had an encounter with you. Even at that early, tender age, you were able to walk with him. Through thick and thin, you moved on with him. And you... Let us pray. He was undergoing. And how I pray that this morning, we will choose your route. Your route is perfect. Your ways are good. And the end results are profitable. Unlike following the things of this world. Father, have mercy upon us and help us to open our heart this morning that the Holy Spirit may come in and cleanse our hearts. Where we have given room to the evil one, where we have accommodated bad thoughts, evil thoughts, works of the evil one, that we may remove them. Where we have been misled, Father, bring us back to the track. And King of all the glory, we shall be blessed men and women of you. Because when we choose not to follow you, then we are in that bracket of men and women who are cast. This morning, no one is cast in this church because we are opening up to you that the Holy Spirit may take over. Holy Spirit of God, take over. Holy Spirit of God, convict us about sin. Holy Spirit of God, remind us about righteousness. Holy Spirit of God, help us to know that the King of this world has already been judged, and we also don't want to be judged like them. We want to enjoy life in you, Jesus, now and in the life to come. We live with you forever. And this is our prayer of faith in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
And now commit you into the hands of him who is able and more than able to do immeasurably above all that we pray, all that we imagine. That this great God may remain your pillar. This great God may go with you. This great God may give you victory. The blessings of God Almighty, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen. Let us appreciate God. Thank you so much. We have come to the end of the service and we really want to thank God. Choir, for this session only.